Hello children, let's start with exercise 2.3, question number 4. On dividing x cubed minus 3x square plus x plus 2 by a polynomial gx, the quotient and the remainder were x minus 2, minus 2x plus 4, respectively find gx. Is it? We know this formula. What is the formula here? Dx is equal to gx into qx plus rx. So substituted the value here, qx is x minus 2, rx is minus 2 plus 4, and px is given. So if you want to find gx, then what will happen? This will be subtracted. Okay, this will be subtracted from this and divided by x minus 2 will give you gx. Is it? Because this is a plus sign. So gx is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus x plus plus x plus 2 minus x minus 2 plus 4 divided by x minus 2. So gx is equal. If you open the bracket, simplify it, you'll get this is. Then if you simplify it this further, you'll get x minus 2 cancel. So gx will be x squared minus x plus 1. So let us start with the now exercise 2.4, question number 1. What is that for question number 1? Verify that the number given along the line side alongside of a cubic polynomial below are their zeros. Verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient in each cases. Is it? You have to find this, okay, this whether it is zeros or not. So let's see. P of half first. Is it? So it is equal to 0. So half is the P of half. So therefore it implies that half is the zeros of Px. Is it? Not P. Is it? So half is the zeros of Px. Here it is 0. Therefore P1 is or P. 1 is the zeros of this. 1 is the zeros of Px. If you say minus 2, then here it also becomes 0. So minus 2 is a zeros of Px. Is it? Okay. And then what is given as 0? What is given as minus 2? Then it is 1. If we check for 1, it is also 0. So again, x minus 1 is a factor of Px. Is it? Then this is second one. It is 2x cubed. Then x minus 1, or we can say x plus 2, and 2x minus 1. Is it? If you simplify this, what do you get? If you simplify this one, plus 2, you have to simplify, it becomes 0. Is it? So x minus 1 is a factor of this. This is a continuous whether factor or not. So if you express it, you'll get x is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 2, and half. Is it? These are the factor. Instead of doing that, you can directly do alpha plus beta alpha. Then if you find it, alpha beta gamma. Is it? Alpha beta gamma. Then you'll get minus 1 upon 2. Which is that? What is that? Is it? So actually no need of doing that. This is already given. Okay, no need of doing this. Is it? We found that it is a 0. First question was, verify the number given alongside cubic polynomial are 0. So we proved it is become equal to 0. So it is proved that 1, minus 2 and half are the zero, are the required zeros of polynomials. Now we have to verify the relation. So first is alpha beta gamma. Alpha beta gamma, if we add it, you'll get, simplifying it, you'll get minus 1 upon 2. Is it? Minus 1 upon 2. So we can split it and write minus 1 upon 2. Minus of minus 1 upon 2. But what is a minus 1? Minus 1 is the what given equation. It's a coefficient of x square. Is it? Minus 1 inside, so here will be plus. It is minus 1 by 2, so minus 1 inside and outside plus. is it? Minus 1 is 2. But what is a minus 1? If you see the required equation here. Okay. Minus 1 is a sign. What is a coefficient? 1. 1 upon 2. 1 by 2. 1 by 2 or 1. It is a coefficient of x square. 2. It is a coefficient of x cube. So, here, minus sign outside. Then, it is a coefficient of x square. So, you have to keep like this. Okay. Sorry. It is, it should be like this. Minus 1 and 1 inside. So, minus 1 for the relation. So, it is a coefficient of, and is it minus 1 outside? Minus 1 is first. What is the sum of roots? Sum of root is minus b upon a. Is it? Minus b upon a. So, it is minus. Then 1 is that coefficient of x square. And 2 is what? Coefficient of x cube. Now, product of sum of this product of root. If you find the sum of the product of root, then is it, if simplifying it, you will get minus 5. Minus 5. Is it? What is a minus 5? If you see what is minus 5, it's a coefficient of x. Is it? So in place of minus 5, we can write coefficient of x. And what is 2? Coefficient of x cube. Is it? Third one is alpha into beta, product of root. If you say product of root, whatever root given, then you can get final answer as minus 2, minus of minus 2, is it? Minus constant term. Constant term is what? Plus. Is it? Okay. And coefficient of x cube. Find a cubic polynomial with the sum of product of zeros taken two at a time. And the product of zero are 2, minus 7 and minus 14. Sum of root means 3 given, it is that alpha beta gamma is equal to 2, that is given, and product of zeros. Sum of product of 0 means alpha into beta, beta into alpha, alpha into gamma. This is their sum of product of zeros. This is third one. It is product of zeros. Product of zeros means alpha into beta into gamma. Is it? The first thing, what I say, the sum. Sum means alpha plus beta plus gamma. Is it? When alpha, beta, gamma is given. Is it? Alpha plus beta plus gamma. Second is sum of product of zero. Sum of product of zero is alpha into beta, beta into gamma plus gamma into alpha. Okay. Third one, the product of zeros. The product of zeros are alpha into beta into gamma. This is given. So what is actually given? So let px is equal to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d be the required cubic polynomial, and alpha, beta, gamma be the zeros. Then what is given? Sum is 2. So alpha plus beta, sum of the zeros is 2. So alpha plus gamma plus alpha, beta, gamma is equal to 2. But what is 2? But what is actually should be minus b upon a. Is it? Okay. So what is b? Here it is given as, is it? So it implies is equal to minus 2. Then alpha into beta into gamma. The product of root is given as what? Minus 7. Minus 7 means we can get it as c upon a. Here 1. Okay. Is it? If you take 1, then what is that? Minus 7. Alpha into beta into gamma. But what is alpha beta? Sum of product of zeros taken at a time is c upon a. Is it? Is equal to c upon a. Implies c upon a is equal to minus 7. Implies it is minus 7. No, wow. So, and alpha into beta into gamma is equal to 14, minus 14, that is d upon a. Is it? A is taken as 1. So, minus of minus. Minus d is there, but d is minus 14. So, minus of minus will make it plus. Plus 14. Is it? Is equal to 14. Is it? So A is equal to 1 if we take, B is equal to minus 2, C is equal to 7 and D is equal to 14. Then the required quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial will be substituted the value of here A, B, C, D. You will get the required, what is that, cubic polynomial. Is it? What is the question number 3? If the zeros of polynomial x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 1 are a minus b, a plus b, find a and b. Is it? First, what is saying? It is a minus b means the sum of the roots. Sum of the root means a, b, c is given alpha, beta, gamma. Is it? And then second is that the sum of the product of root. The sum of the product of root means alpha into beta plus beta into alpha plus alpha into gamma is equal to A. Third one, alpha beta gamma is equal to, will be equal to A plus B. That is what is given to us. Is it? So sum of the zeros means alpha beta gamma. Is it? Okay, if you add it, alpha is A minus B, beta is A, and gamma is A plus B. If you simplify it, you will get 3A. Now, but the sum of the zeros is equal to what? The sum of the zero is minus B upon A. Is it? From this equation, B is minus 3 and A is 1. Is it? A is 1. So B by A will become minus 3 upon A. Minus of minus 3 upon A, that is equal to 3. So 3A will be equal to 3. So A is equal to 1. You got it? Now the product of its sum. Is it? Product of its sum. If you multiply it, A into B, B into A is equal to what you should get? The product of sum. So we have to add it, multiply it and add it. Product of zeros means multiplication of all three. If you multiply all three, a minus b into a plus b is a square minus b square into a. Is it? Okay. But what is the product of zero? Product of zero is minus d upon a. So according to here, what is d? 1 upon a is also 1. So minus 1. So it will be equal to minus. The product of zero is, product of zeros is minus d upon a, that is minus 1. Is it? Equal to minus 1. So this will be equal to minus 1. Quickly equate. The value of a we got 1 is also 1 and b is equal to minus 1. If you substitute the value of a here, is it? Then you will get b square. B square is equal to 1 plus 1, 2. So b square is equal to, we will take out the 2. This is not possible. Okay. Square, if you take out minus, it is not possible. You have to take root, plus minus. Minus is not possible of root. So b is equal to plus minus root 2. Is it? And a is equal to 1, we already found. If two zeros of polynomial x4 minus 3x cube minus 26x square plus 138x minus 35 are 2 plus minus root 3, find the other zeros. So we have to find the factor, then divide this factor by this. Okay, then you will get px, and equate px is equal to 0, you will get the remaining zeros. So 2 plus minus root 3 are the zeros of polynomial px. Therefore x minus, is it, plus root 3, and x minus root 3 is also a factor of zeros. Is it? is also a factor of px, not zeros. It's also a factor of px. Therefore, if you take this x minus 2 plus x plus root 3, x minus 2 minus root 3, so this will become a, this become b. So this is a and b. So a plus b is a square minus b square. So x minus 2 whole square minus root cube root 3 whole square. If you simplify this, is it? And this says 3 minus, and or we can simplify a minus b plus b. Simplify it, open the bracket, what you get? X square minus 4x plus 2 minus root 3. Root 3 is 3. If you open the bracket, you'll get x square minus 4x plus 4 minus 3 minus 3. So 3, 4 minus 3 is 1. So x square minus 4x plus 1. Is it? If you equate this, this is not. Now divide this polynomials, given polynomial by this, you'll get x square minus 2x plus 35. Is it? To find the remaining zeros, equate qx is equal to 0. Okay, to find the remaining zeros of px, let qx is equal to 0. What is qx? Qx is x squared minus 2x minus 35. So x squared minus 2x minus 35 is equal to 0. If you simplify, you'll get x is equal to 7 or x is equal to minus 5. So x is equal to 7, okay, and minus 5 are the remaining zeros of px. So the remaining zeros of px are 7 and minus 5. Is it clear? Okay. If the polynomial x square x raised to 4 minus 6x square plus 6x square 16x square minus 25x plus 10 is divided by another polynomial, find the remaining remainder outcome of 2b x plus a, then find k and a. So you have to divide it. This is how. Okay, x square minus 2x, x square minus 2x plus k. If you divide it, okay, this division is little bit tedious, is it? X square, so it is x raised to 4, so multiply with x square, you have to keep to get x raised to 4, so multiply it. So x square x raised to 4, then multiply this with minus x2 x raised to cube, then multiply this, which will be kx square. If you change the sign and cancel this, is it? Remaining will be plus minus. Plus minus, this sign is to be considered. So plus minus minus, it is minus 4x cube, now it is k, is it? So nothing, you have to keep it separate, you cannot be cut with this x square, this k constant, here is 16, so value may be anything, so we cannot simplify it, so you have to write plus 16x square minus kx square, then 25, x plus 10. Now what you have to cancel, we have to multiply with, what is here? X square. What is here? X raised to cube. So we have to multiply with x. And what is the constant here? Nothing. Here it is that minus 4. So we have to multiply with this x square with minus 4x. So multiply with minus 4x. So what I get? Minus 4x into this. Minus 4x cube. Then minus 4x into 2. Minus into minus plus 8x square. 8x square, then 4x into k minus 4kx, is it? Okay, then you again change the sign, so it will cancel out. This you can simplify, it is minus, so minus 8x plus 8x square minus this k square will nothing to be done, which you should be keep like this only, don't simplify it. Okay, so minus kx square minus 4kx, then it is 25 x plus 10, is it? Now what left here, it is x square, it is the same, you have to multiply with this x square with constant 8, is it? Okay, but what is the problem? X square is here also x square, so 2, so if you take x square common, you will get 8 minus k, so instead of multiplying with 8 only, you have to multiply with 8k, 8 minus k, so you have to multiply this with 8 minus k to cancel this out. Okay, so multiply with 8 minus k, so x square 8 minus k x square plus 8 minus k into 2. Okay, so 2 outside the bracket, 8 minus k into x, you keep like this. Okay, then you multiply with k, multiply with k, 8k multiply with k, so you have to keep it here, it is okay. If you multiply with that, you have to keep it here, 8 to the 16, so you multiply it with 16, Here you multiply this and this one. So you will get minus. Then if you multiply 2 inside, so you get 2 8 16, okay, 16, and 2k minus 2k, and x will be outside, is it? Then you multiply with 8k into k, so k 8k 8 minus k plus 10, is it? Now you cancel out, so this will be cancelling out. Now you have to take common and simplify this. Take x common and simplify this. So minus into minus plus, so how much total k it becomes? 4 plus 2 6, okay, 6k, is it? Then minus and minus, so it is plus, so you'll keep it here, plus here. Then if you simplify this, no, so I think this plus sign, you don't have to say this sign you have to take. So if you multiply this, simplify plus, so it will become plus. This will become plus means 2 4 minus 2 4 minus 2 2, it is. And this also become plus because this sign we are using, so this is, this will also become plus. So 25 minus 25 plus 16, you will get minus 9k x, okay. Then constant, okay, constant you are getting. Now you multiply here, so you will get minus k, this is minus. Now this sign is minus, so minus k, 8 minus a in the bracket, 8 minus k plus 10, okay, understand? This will be cancelling down. Comparing the question as given as x plus 10, I think. Given as x plus 10, okay. Then what will you get comparing the question? Then what do you get? 2, this is the x, okay. Compare with that x, so x is what? 2k minus 9. X value of x is what? 1. So 2k minus 9 is equal to 1, so k is equal to 5, is it? And compare this as a, it is equal to a, so it is k, all things is all minus k, 8k plus 10 is equal to a, okay. Then we will get a value of a as minus 5, okay.